So here with Joe Miller for an update. He is a councillor for the Rottingdean Coastal Ward. We're going to start off with Madeira Terraces. Joe, I know there's been a lot of work behind the scenes, but what's the latest with the Madeira Terraces? Because no actual work seems to have got done from kind of, you know, the layman's perspective anyway.
Yes, well, it is frustratingly slow, but there is these kind of projects do require a lot of time initially to get them right, I suppose. And there has been some delays around procurement. Obviously, we have to go through procurement processes to make sure council taxpayers' money is being spent correctly and with, you know, proper companies, etc. So there is there's a time delay around that, and there are some time delays around planning as well. The most frustrating delay, we are still planning to start in 2022, hopefully summer, autumn 2022, is the council's own highways department that appeared to be bringing difficulties in relation to parking configurations and arguing that they should get some of the money from the budget if there is any loss of one or two parking spaces along Madeira Drive, etc., or more parking spaces. And so that's really a fly in the ointment. Obviously, you don't want to spend a huge chunk of money making something really beautiful to park a load of cars in front of it. Whether those parking spaces are going to be reprovided up on the upper level is hopefully going to be a solution. So those are the reasons for some of the delays around this.
Yeah,
because I know there is progress. The good news is there is progress. There is slow progress. Yeah. I would like to see progress faster, obviously.
Yeah, I mean, the sad thing about Madeira Terrace is every year goes by, you know, every year it does go by, you know, when no work, remedial work's been goes on, then it just has another winter where it further deteriorates. It's heartbreaking in a way.
Well, and as a result, it'll cost more to fix, or more of it require, more of it will require more extensive repairs. And so it is, you know, like everything, isn't it? If you neglect something for long enough, it'll end up falling down, and it's costs a lot more to rebuild than it does to repair.
So
the council do need to act quickly on this, and we need to identify, and calling on the Greens administration to identify the funds to provide the remainder of the phases to be restored their former glory. It's always our party in opposition that have to seem to find the money via budget amendment. I'd like to see the Greens actually put some money into it themselves.
Talking of the budget, Joe, that's coming up, isn't it? There's a long process which is going to start shortly up until February 2022. Tell us a bit about the budget expectations. I spoke to Councillor David Gibson this week from the Green administration, and he was saying it was probably going to have to be cuts, or there's going to be a deficit, and they don't know how to fit it.
Well, I mean, there is... we did very well last year as a result of the government grants through COVID and assistance through COVID. There are, as ever, increasing service demand areas on the council. And really, it's when there are cuts from government funding, etc. In fact, the revenue support grant, which the government gives the council last year, actually increased. So they're not cuts to services. What effectively David's trying to say is that the council tax and fee increases that the council can make aren't large enough to meet the increased service demand pressures, because the service demand pressures, such as around adult social care and children's services and homelessness, are increasing and cost more at a faster rate than the council's ability to raise money to pay for those. And that really goes to the point about how efficient we are as an organisation, and the council is inefficient in my view. There is a lot of waste. There are lessons that could be learned from other service areas, but that requires strong political will in order to deliver those. And we've recently seen with the settlement for the GMB bin strike that was never about pay, the millions of pounds of settlement year on year to council budget resources, and indeed this current financial year, which will become a budget pressure, that's obviously exacerbated the budget gap, as such, as we call it, the difference between the money we can bring in and the increase in service demand pressure, the money we spend out. That's increased the budget service gap even more, and David supported that, so he's making a rod for his own back in that sense.
Yeah, it's going to be difficult because last time we actually had a budget. We didn't have the shortfall, did we? We had a surplus. So I mean, is it all adult social care where this money's being spent? I know that with the homeless crisis in the city, that's cost a lot of money, doesn't it? I mean, what are the big spends in the budget for the council?
Yes, I mean, adult social care and children's services are the biggest spends. Obviously, schools, we kind of receive the money and distribute it, likewise with housing benefit. But our kind of revenue budget is mainly adult social care and children's services and homelessness. They are the largest kind of spend areas and, you know, highest demand areas, demand-led increases on those areas, which are affecting the council's budget. Those in need and the vulnerable are requiring more and more intervention assistance, and lots of that is as a result of, or partly as a result of, COVID as well. So that's really why those areas are requiring further financial investment.
Yeah, and just before we finish up, I mean, on the budget, the process there, I mean, you'll be able to submit amendments, won't you, as well, and that they'll be discussed at the full council meeting, which is next February. But I guess you've got ideas about where you'd want to kind of, you know, get some wins.
Yes, indeed. And it really does depend on what the draft budget looks like. And there may be service areas, as we saw some time ago when Labour decided to propose cutting the entire youth service, which we saved. So it really does depend on where they're finding the money from and how ethical those findings are, in order to see where we focus our efforts, really. Whether it be to save services that are being reduced, or whether those are sensible sort of efficiency measures that the council trying to work better and work smarter that are leading to those savings, or which will enable us to spend on opportunity or growth areas as such. But it really does depend on what's in the Greens draft budget.
Yeah, and that's a watching brief, of course, and we'll hear from you, you know, later on in the process. Saltdean Lido, then, that's been a few six. It's been a success story. It has been open, hasn't it, over the summer that's just gone?
Yes, it is a success story. And it's good to see that the working through the HLF guidance, the council now, as a result of our budget amendment last year, they maxed out on their HLF grant, which means that hopefully we'll soon see work start later on this year or early next year. And that's really exciting. To bring the building back into its use as the swim pool is, and it's getting a high local use and across the city, providing a much needed facility. So that's really exciting.
Yeah, exactly. Full council just gone as well. We're going to have to reconvene. Any news on that? Obviously, it got cut short. I was there. You were there. It got cut short, didn't it? For the full council meeting.
Yes, it did. Yes, unfortunately, it did. And I think the councillor in question didn't feel particularly well, and obviously didn't feel so well that he had to take a PCR test. So it's questionable as to why you would attend a meeting if you were displaying symptoms and tested for that. To then attend is somewhat questionable, which is not particularly helpful, I don't think, and led to the business all having to be carried over to the December meeting, where I'm sure we'll have a very even fuller agenda.
Yeah, exactly. Looking forward to it. So that's Councillor Joe Miller. All the best, Joe. We'll catch up again soon, particularly with the budget. Thanks a lot.
Thanks.